Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everybody. My name is Mauro Rossi, and I'm a researcher of the Italian National Research Council. And today, on behalf of the co-authors, I will present a first draft of the glossary for the landslide early warning system. Well, this activity is within the working group one, within the land aware community. And the main objective is to provide a description of the state-of-the-art existing landslide early warning system in a form of a catalog. This clearly needs to define a common terminology and some common descriptors, even to facilitate future addendum. The first step was the review of the existing international terminology and definition used within the landslide early warning system community, even to share a common understanding of the system and of their components. The second step will be the preparation of the catalog. Why we need a dedicated glossary? But first, whenever we need to design and implement an early warning system, a landslide early warning system, we need to have multidisciplinary specialists from many fields that needs to communicate, interact during the system implementation. But this is not really straightforward and efficient. In addition, there are many regional or local terminological differences that makes really difficult to share the implementation experiences. Under this perspective, the sharing of a common terminology and having a dedicated glossary is fundamental to build and to smooth the knowledge transfer, even with the public. Basically, we started with the collection and review of all the articles from the impacted scientific literature, and we were extracting some specific terms. We were collecting existing glossaries, and we were creating a list of terms giving definition from both the sources. The creation of this shared list of references was formalized in a given format that we will see later. We were even contacting EIG landslide nomenclature responsibilities. The glossary this was prepared basically by me, by Graziella, by Engel and Hero, and minor amendments and suggestions coming from Minu, Samuele, Davide and Michele, some participants to the working group. Let's start describing the glossary structure. There is a list of items that we need to compile whenever we want to add a term into the glossary. First is the term itself, then there is a short definition, then there is the abbreviation and some synonyms. Then we classify these terms in four categories related to disaster risk knowledge, detection, monitoring, analysis and forecasting, warning, dissemination and communication, preparedness and response capabilities. Then we were giving a link to the source and even references when appropriate. This is how the table that is containing the terms and the different items is resembling. We have in this case the term local landslide early warning system. We have the definition, we have the abbreviation, we have the synonym, and we have the element that we use to classify this term, plus the link to the source, that in this case is a DOI, and the link to a reference. If we want to give a bit more example, this table is containing an additional terms. What we want to share with you is the fact that there are, in some cases, some repetitions because some of the terminology were used and were defined by different sources and by different authors. So this is something that we need to deal with when we'll finalize the glossary. As we said before, we were taking the impacted journals and we were selecting some really interesting papers on these journals. Here we see some of these papers that we were selecting, and we were reading to extract some of the terminology that was inserted in the draft glossary. But we even looked to the glossaries and technical to other glossaries and to the technical literature. In this case, we were presenting here some reports or some glossaries coming from the UNDRR or from the National Weather Services, and there are many of these already considered in the first glossary draft. Well, we have a roadmap to finalize the glossary. First, we need to finalize this first draft version. Then the idea is to distribute this to WG1 group and to other land aware members for a final revision. And then we need to push the distribution of the glossary to the community. What we want to discuss during this May Day 2021 is first deciding what should be the format for the glossary publication. We should establish some feedback mechanisms that is really important for future amendments and for future updates of the glossary. We were preparing a first attempt to try to get an evaluation from you that is formalized in this Google form. Here you will have the possibility to decide and to specify how much you believe a term should be important for the glossary. Then we need to establish how to communicate with WG1 or to LandAware in general. And we were thinking that it's important to have a review by some invited experts that are not present within the working group. Then we need to establish some glossary dissemination strategies and even deciding what will be the future update frequency of the glossary. So with this, I will stop the presentation and I will leave the audience to express your opinion in regarding these elements that we were presenting in this last slide. Thank you very much. Thank you for being here, and hope we'll have an interesting discussion in the following.